As we discussed, that all the semiconductor instruments need PN junction. There are, you can say, unijunction devices, and this is bijunction devices, and this is the practical which we are going to discuss today, that is PN junction diode. And next slide, please. Okay, in this experiment, the main part of experiment, we have to draw the characteristics of PN junction diode. And in this way, we will discuss what are our objective and what is the introduction about semiconductor and PN junction diode and apparatus used, which we will use here, and what theories are involved there, and procedures, which procedures we will follow, find the observation. These nine steps. Next slide. Meenakshi, please.
Sir, I am in objective slide, sir.
Okay, next slide, please.
Introduction slide, sir. This one?
Okay. By performing this experiment, we will able to know. We will able to know about what are the semiconductors and how they perform, and what is the characteristics of the semiconductors, and in which the semiconductor can be used. And this is the introduction part of, if we all know, there are many materials in nature, and out of these materials, some are insulators, some are conductors, and some are semiconductors. The conductors and insulators are known to all of you. Conductors, here, the meaning of conductor means electrical conductors. The conductors are materials in which the current can pass easily with almost no resistance or very.
Sir, please unmute yourself. Deepak sir, please unmute yourself.
Okay. So I am saying about the conductor, insulator, and semiconductors. Conductors are the materials in which current can easily pass with no resistance or almost zero resistance or very little resistance. And second type of material is insulator. This is known to you, all of you. It means in which the material, in which the current cannot pass or.
Sir, you are not audible, sir.
Conductivity and conductivities are two terms to define any material. And conductivity, and for the case of conductor, or you can say metal, the question is that how we define conductivity or resistivity. So the answer is very simple. Conductivity means the resistance, how a material offer resistance to current. And here, these two are characteristics of any material. And we know the in metal, this is the metal. In metal, there are many number of, large number of free electrons inside the metals, which define conductivity, which make the material conductive, because there are very large amount of electron to conduct, to move inside the metal. But other case in for insulator, there are not sufficient number of electrons inside the insulator, which can conduct current, which can move inside the insulator. It means no electron to conduct, or you can say no charge particle to conduct. One important thing is there, when the temperature raises, if the temperature increased, if we increase the temperature of any metal, or you can say conductor, then conductivity decreases, because effect of temperature increases more collision amongst electrons inside metal, and which it means more collision between the electrons, it means less time to, it means large time to go one point to another point, it means the resistances will increase. And but beside these two type of material, I discussed two type of material. This is first one is conductor, and second one is insulator or not non-conductor. Besides these two type of conductor, we have another type of material. These are called semiconductor. The meaning of semiconductor means the conductivity, they are not a good conductor or not a bad insulator. This is between these two. It means conductivity is lower than conductor, but it is higher than insulator. So these material are very important to us. And as I discussed, the semiconductor are the material whose conductivity is between conductor and insulator. Meenakshi, please, next slide. And now we have some materials like silver, copper, aluminum, iron. These are good conductor. And glass, wood, quartz, rubber. These are bad conductor, or you can say insulator. And semiconductors are, some common semiconductors are germanium and silicon. And these are, you can say, in right table, these materials are defined in terms of their resistivity. The resistivity is order of 10 to the power minus 8. It means low resistivity means good conductor. And resistivity is about 10 to the power 14. It means it is bad conductor. Resistivity is very high. But the conductivity, the resistivity between 0.46, it means it is, the conductivity is again between conductor and insulator. So this is these are some example of conductor, insulator, and semiconductor. Next slide, please. Okay, now the physics. What is the physics in what theory behind it? How the material can defined? So these are defined in terms of band gap. Very interesting terms, which I am going to discuss. Listen carefully. This is band gap. It means material can be defined in terms of band gap. Band gap, it means in metal, or in, you can say, any type of material, there are two band, that is called conduction band and valence band. Conduction band, it means if we think about the electron, and we know that there is an atom, there is a nucleus, and electrons are surrounding the nucleus. But in case of metal, some electrons present inside the atom, which are free to move inside the material. It means they are free to move. They are loosely attached to the atom. They are loosely attached to the nucleus. They can move freely inside the metal. So these electrons are called conduction electrons. Free electrons, that these are called conduction electrons. These electrons are responsible for making a material very good conductor. So this is conductivity. This is, but an energy level of these electrons are called conduction energy. And suppose there are many atoms present in the metal, and when they combine, so they form a band. This is called conduction band. It means the combination of energy level of all conduction electron inside atom is called conduction band. Energy level high. And secondly, valence band means the electron which are very tightly attached to the nucleus. They cannot move inside metal. They cannot move inside material. So this is called, these are called valence electron. So, and now, if there are many atoms present in the material, then the combination of these all, the energy, just I'm repeating, energy of valence electron is called valence energy. And if there are many atoms present in material, they combine, so they form band, not a particular energy. They form a band. So energy level of these electron, the valence electron is called conduction band, valence band. Means we have two band. One is conduction band. The electron in conduction band can move freely inside material. And second is valence band. The electron in valence band cannot move freely inside the material. And if the conductivity of any material is defined by conduction band, if large number of free electrons, it means a large number of electron in conduction band, it means the material is good conductor. And if less number of valence electron, if less number of conduction electron, or you can say less number of free electron, it means less electrons to move inside the material. It means less, and which is insulator? Insulator, it means it is one whose conduction band is fully empty. And valence band is fully filled, you can say. And what is the conductor? The conductor means whose conduction band have electrons, is not fully empty. And what happens if there is a gap between these two? It means there is a gap of energy between the valence band and conduction band. And if it is for case of insulator, it is around 9 electron volt. 9 electron volt is very high energy. It means when a electron is accelerated by 1 volt, then electron will acquire 1 electron volt. It means 9 electron volt is very high energy. Atomic dimensions, you can say. For atomic scale, it is very high energy. So 9 electron volt, around 9, if the gap between the conduction band and valence band is very high, it is around 9 electron volt, then it is not easy to move a valence electron to the conduction band. And such material are called insulator. This is very interesting. And secondly, if a valence band and conduction band are overlapped, if they overlap, it means valence electron are conduction electron, and valence electron can move to conduction band. It means this is conductor. Overlap means they are mixed. Valence band and conduction band are mixed. And beside the right of this slide is conductor. Valence band and conduction band are overlapped. And left part of slide is insulator, and very high gap. Gap means this is the gap of energy. And beside these two, there is a middle. In middle, there is a gap around 1 electron volt. It is not very high, very large, or not very low. The material which is in middle are called semiconductor. It means semiconductor if I say that semiconductor at 0 degree Kelvin, semiconductor, this is insulator, because there is a little gap, and any material can gain energy by the temperature. If temperature is very low, around 0 degree Kelvin, it means there is no almost empty conduction band and almost full valence band, but the valence electron have not sufficient energy to go inside to jump to the conduction band. It means the semiconductor which we are saying conduct semiconductors, it will act as a insulator at very high temperature. On next slide, please. Okay, now the questions. Before in second slide, I discuss you about some example of semiconductors, and I told you the examples are silicon and germanium. Very common examples are, and besides this, there are indium, arsenide, and many other organic molecules are used as a semiconductors. And I want to discuss you that germanium and silicon are semiconductor whose band gap is, germanium ka jo band gap hai is 0.67 electron volt, and the band gap of silicon is 1.14 electron volt. I am saying the band gap of germanium is 0.67 electron volt, and band gap of silicon is 1.14 electron volt. It is at 273 degree Kelvin. Band gap, you can say this is dependent on some temperature. So we can easily say that band gap is not too high as in case of insulator, and it is not too low as in case of conductor. So if we look about silicon and germanium atoms, silicon atom, its atomic number is 14, and germanium, its atomic number is 32. If we place the number of electron in orbit, then it is 2, 8, and 4. It means there are 4 electrons in outermost orbit. This is the same case for germanium, whose atomic number is 32. So both silicon and germanium atom have 4 electrons in the outermost orbit, or you can say valence orbit, the outermost orbit. And we know for the stability of atom, we need 8 electrons. And for stability, what germanium and silicon do? They will combine to their neighboring atom by covalent bond. Covalent bond means sharing of electrons. So by sharing their electrons, the silicon atom form a silicon lattice, or you can say silicon material, you can say, which is, you can see in the silicon atom, all, it means the center atom, you can look for the center silicon atom. It have 4 electron, and 1 electron will be shared by this neighboring right silicon atom, and 1 by left silicon, and 1 by top, and 1 by below. You can say, it means the outermost electron have 8 electron. Stability come for the silicon. So for that, you can look, next slide, please. Next slide. Okay, thank you. This is again a picture of silicon. The if we look the left picture, the silicon lattice, all the silicon atom completes its stability factor of 8 electron in outermost orbit. So it means in left picture, for the silicon atom, the lattice, it is a, you can say it is stable. If you look, if there is 2 degree, if there is 0 degree Kelvin, or you can say very low temperature, we can easily say that there is no electron which is free inside lattice. Silicon lattice have no electron because all electrons are bonded by covalent bond. It means we can see easily that that silicon material, silicon lattice, is will not be a good conductor because no electron to conduct. But what happens in right picture? Here what happens that if temperature increases, when the temperature increases, some of covalent bond breaks. Because what temperature, what covalent bond is not very, you can say strong bond. It is, so some of bond will break and electron, when the bond break, then electron will be, electron get free. Electron, and now this electron, and place of electron, when from the electron comes, when the electrons will be free, which will move inside the lattice, and where, from where the electron will come, will create the vacancy of electron. That is called hole. It means the same time the electrons creates, then hole also create. The question is how? Now the place of hole, which is the vacancy of electron, that will be filled by its neighboring atom. जो इसके बगल वाले इलेक्ट्रॉन से एटम से इलेक्ट्रॉन फ्री होगा वो यहाँ फिल हो जाएगा और वहां पर फिर होल क्रिएट होगा और इस ढंग से होल का मूवमेंट होता है एक पॉइंट से. इट मीन्स इलेक्ट्रॉन मूव कर रहा है तो होल भी मूव कर रहा है. इट मीन्स देर इज वेयर नाउ बाई टेम्परेचर, बाई इंक्रीजिंग टेम्परेचर, वी हैव टू थिंग. That is, electron become free for conduction, and again hole. There is, it means there is the production of electron and hole. Hole means vacancy of electrons. So this is now. It means at 0 degree Kelvin or very very low temperature, the semiconductor which act as as insulator. It will act as conductor. At high temperature, because it has free electron. Now this electron can freely move from one point to another point. So the left picture is picture of insulator, and right picture is the picture of conductor. Material is same, but temperature play a role. And interestingly, next slide. And interestingly, if you saw that the conductivity. It means the silicon atom or germanium atom will be very, its conductivity will increases as temperature increases. As temperature increases, more bonds break, and more bonds break means more electrons free will get free, and it means the material become more conductive. So this is called positive, the negative temperature gradient. We can say that semiconductor are negative temperature coefficient of resistance. Matlab hai, the resistance decreases with increasing temperature. Conductor, where in case of metal mein kya hota hai? टेम्परेचर के साथ रेजिस्टिविटी रेजिस्टेंस बढ़ता है, नॉट रेजिस्टिविटी, टेम्परेचर के साथ रेजिस्टेंस बढ़ता है. यहाँ पर उल्टा हो रहा है, टेम्परेचर के साथ रेजिस्टेंस कम हो रहा है. तो दे आर नेगेटिव टेम्परेचर कोफिशियंट ऑफ रेजिस्टेंस, वेयर एज मेटल आर पॉजिटिव टेम्परेचर कोफिशियंट ऑफ रेजिस्टेंस. नाउ दिस इज इंटरेस्टिंगली, इफ यू आर नॉट एबल टू सी इट, तो प्लीज जूम दिस पिक्चर. तो this is the semiconductor again device defined as intrinsic type of semiconductor and extrinsic type of semiconductor. The intrinsic type of semiconductor means the semiconductor, you can say that as carbon, sorry, you can say, as you can say, silicon and germanium, when they are used in its pure form, this is called intrinsic type of semiconductor. It means as found in nature. Germanium and silicon, as found in nature, when they used, when they studied, they are called intrinsic type of semiconductor. But this intrinsic type of semiconductor have limitations in term of conductivity. It means if you want to raise the conductivity, then we have only one factor to increase the conductivity of intrinsic type of semiconductor, that is temperature. If temperature increases, then conductivity increases. It means we are dependent on temperature. It means this is not beneficial for us. So for that, for increasing the conductivity of material to materials, we add some impurity part. Impurity means other than germanium, or you can say other than silicon. So we add some impurity to pure germanium crystal, or you can say to pure germanium or silicon crystal, you can say. So this is called doping. Doping means adding impurity. Impurity ko add karna, that is called doping. It means when we doped in pure germanium and silicon crystal by some impurity, then the material become more conductive, good conductor, and such material are called extrinsic type semiconductor. We have basically two types of semiconductor. First is pure germanium and silicon, and second is impure, you can say, which we make by doping. And extrinsic type of semiconductors are good conductor. It means, and conductivity of extrinsic type of semiconductors depends on doping. If we add more impurity, conductivity will be increased. If we add less impurity, conductivity will decrease. It means we are not dependent on temperature. It means conductivity can be increased by doping. So there are two type of semiconductors. First one is, you can say, that is P type of semiconductors and N type of semiconductors. Just think, if we add pentavalent impurity to silicon. Pentavalent means phosphorus. Phosphorus arsenic type impurity, then what happens? Phosphorus have 5 electron in their valence orbit. So 4 electron will make bond, because silicon have 4 electron, and it need again 4 electrons. Then what happens? 4 electron will make bond, and 1 electron will free. Okay, it means when one electron, there is one electron per bond, per impurity atom is free. And if we add more atom, it means we have more free electrons. It means the material will be good conductor. It is interesting to note down that conductivity, when we add pentavalent impurity to the pure germanium or pure silicon atom, then one free electron will be available. And this such extrinsic semiconductors are called n-type semiconductor. N means electron available, which have negative charge. And for negative, it doesn't mean that material will become negative. The whole semiconductor will be neutral. And second type of semiconductor is P type of semiconductor. This is the same thing. If we add trivalent impurity to the pure silicon or pure germanium atom, then what happens? Like aluminium, boron, they have, they are trivalent. It means they have three electrons in their outermost orbit. Then what happens now? Silicon needs four electrons to complete their orbit, but aluminium have three. Then what will happen? Three electron will make bond. But four electron will be borrowed by neighboring atom. It means that fourth place is called vacancy of electron. That is called hole. It means now there is a hole. So this is called, the charge of hole is positive. So this is called P type of semiconductor. Next slide, please. Okay. It is again shown, which I call you. It is shown that is aluminium atom added to silicon atom. So this is one. This is presence. This is four electron needed. So this is presence of hole. Incomplete covalent bond. To make it complete, some electron will come from neighboring atom. That is called hole. Next. Meenakshi, next slide. Okay. And here again, I show you the formation of N-type of extrinsic semiconductor. Same case, arsenic is added to silicon and one extra electron present in the lattice. Next. Okay. Now it is interesting to see this slide. This is P-type of semiconductor, N-type of semiconductor. Students, listen carefully. P-type of semiconductors and N-type of semiconductors are made for getting more conducting semiconductor. The next picture, which is P-type of semiconductor, it have a hole and a negative ion. Why it is negative ion? Ion means negative ion of which? It means which the that is aluminium, or you can say boron, which donate, which accept. This is the P type of semiconductor is the combination of negative acceptor ion and hole. This is hole. And N type of semiconductor is positive donor ions and electrons. It is very clear that P type of semiconductors have majority of hole. N type of semiconductor have majority of electron. And in P type of semiconductor, there may be some minority of electron due to the temperature. And again, in N type of semiconductor, there may be some hole due to the temperature effect. So it means in P type of semiconductor, majority is hole, minority is electron. N type of semiconductor, majority is electron and minority in hole. So this is very careful to note it, to understand it. Next, please. Okay. This is again review, which I write it review. The P-type material is one which hole are majority charge carrier and electrons are minority charge carrier, whereas in N-type of semiconductor, electrons in majority, in N-type, electrons in majority and hole in minority. Next. Okay, now, so this is the theory. This is the theory part of this is the practical. You can note down all theories. When you will write the practical in your notebook, then write the first is objective and second is, you can say theory of theory. So you can note down the theories in your practical notebook and the apparatus which we are going to use. for that practical purposes, that is PN junction diode, milliammeter for measuring forward current, micrometer for measuring forward current, rheostat is for adjusting voltage, for changing voltage, voltmeter measuring voltage, battery, it is a source of energy, and connection wires to connect all the terminals. Next, please. Okay, now the interesting part, which is the which concern to our practical, ki how the junction formed, that is called formation of a PN junction diode. So this is very interesting, ki when P-type material and N-type materials are diffused. Diffused means, again, diffused, this is a technology, diffusion is a technology of, you can say, by this technology, one can make the ICs fabrication, or you can say. So diffused means you can just think this is about the mixing of these two type of material, you can say. But not, the junction will not form when we make contact of PNN type of material. It means there should be a diffusion. It means when P type of material, which is in left, and N type of material, which is in right, they diffuse together, they mix together, then what happens? The electrons, the hole in P region will move to side the electrons in N region. It means there will be the movement of hole and electron from one side to the other side. By this, what happens? As electrons and hole are, you can say, they are not heavy as ion, the electron move toward hole from P region will move to N region, and electron from N region will move to P region. Then what happens by this electron and hole recombined, they combined, and they will kill each other. Electron and hole recombined, and again that is called annihilation process. And by this, the energy will liberate it. This energy will go inside the lattice. Then what happens? Ion will be not moved, but charge carrier, electron or hole will move. And by this, what happens? There will be a middle region in which there is no electron and there is no hole. That is called depletion layer. Combine karne se kya hoga ki hole aur electron ek dusre ke wajood ko khatam kar denge, recombined honge, usme kuch energy nikal gayi, wo lattice mein reh jayegi. It means there is a small area which is free from charge carrier, which is free from hole and which is free from electron. That is called depletion region. Charge carrier has been depleted from this region. But there is a black, or you can say blue. But what happens? The ion will be, because ions are heavy, they will not move. So negative ion to left side and right ion to right side. Because they are heavy, they will not move. And for that, what happens? The charge, the region is free from charge carrier, that is called depletion layer. But as negative ion, positive ion, they are separated by some distance. It means they will form a very little battery. It means this region will have some potential, some voltage. So this is called potential barrier. Depletion layer means free from charge carrier. Potential barrier means this is formed by depletion of charge carrier. and due to an iron presence in that region. So this is very, very, you can say, very less amount of you can say energy and potential barrier. मैं थोड़ा सा आपको बताऊं कि जर्मेनियम के केस में ये 0.3 वोल्ट के आसपास होता है, वेरी लिटिल, लाइक लिटिल बैटरी. एंड सिलिकॉन के केस में 0.7 वोल्ट के आसपास होता है. इट मींस फॉर जर्मेनियम इट इज 0.3 वोल्ट एंड फॉर सिलिकॉन इट इज वेरी एंड सिलिकॉन फ्रॉम सिलिकॉन इट इज 0.7 वोल्ट. एंड व्हाट हैपेंस नाउ इफ होल प्रेजेंट्स, इफ यू कैन से व्हाट दिस पोटेंशियल बैरियर डू, दे stop the further movement of charge carrier from one region to another region. So the how the junction formed? Junction is formed by diffusion of p-type region into n-type region, and by this there is some region which is free from charge carrier called deflection layer, and again this deflection layer have voltage around 0.3 to 0.7 voltage. It means it act a little battery. Next please. Okay, this is the trainer box. If you come to the our you can say lab, so this will be trainer box, p-n junction trainer box. So it is simple. This is a p-n junction and this is a voltmeter and ammeter. There are two things which is needed for measuring voltage and measuring current in forward wise and reverse wise. Next please. Okay, now we have p-n junction. I made the symbol of p-n junction, that is by arrow p and by line, that is n. This indicate the current will flow from p to n region. You can say roughly you can understand it. So the diode, what happens diode? Diode can be used in you can say upper picture. You will see that there is rheostat. You can say P is given positive charge. You have a p-n junction. Either side it have n-type material, or another one side it have a p-type material, and another type it have n-type of material. So, junction. When p type of region is given positive and n type of region is given negative, then such biasing is called forward biasing. It means if you give the positive voltage to p type of region of p-n junction and we give negative voltage to n type of p-n junction region and n region of p-n junction, then this is called forward bias, and this is the circuit in lower picture. You can easily see that P is given the positive rheostat, P is connected to rheostat, and rheostat is connected to positive. And rheostat means you can adjust the voltage, you can change, you can increase voltage, you can decrease voltage. And again, there is an ammeter, voltmeter, and ammeter in series. You can say so And forward biasing में होगा क्या? What happens in forward bias? P-type region have a hole, so they will get energy by battery, and they will try to move around the junction. And same thing, then electrons are given negative voltage, and they will again try to go inside to pass the junction. But there is a little barrier in junction, which will stop the flow of electron. When the energy of hole, वो energy हम दे रहे हैं battery लगाकर voltage से, when this energy is increased by voltage of potential barrier, then the charge carrier can cross the junction. It means the current will flow inside the junction. It means when the forward biasing voltage is more than a critical voltage, you can say more than some voltage, more than potential barrier voltage, then the current will start inside the junction. That is called forward current. Next, this is the circuit of reverse biasing. Okay, this is the just opposite of forward. Okay, when we give the negative voltage to P type of material, P region of PN junction, there are two region of PN junction. P region, junction ke do region hai, P region and N region. Agar P region ko aap negative voltage denge aur N region ko aap positive voltage denge, to isko bolte hain reverse bias. And what happens in case of reverse bias? In reverse bias, what happens? The junction will be broadened. Junction aur choda ho jayega. Kyunki already negative hai, hum aur negative de rahe hain. It is junction is negative battery and we are putting again negative energy. It means no current will flow inside the PN junction when it is reverse bias. Forward bias mein current behegi PN junction ke through, reverse bias mein current nahi behegi. But it is an ideal case. If when the this is the ideal case. Hota kya hai? मैंने आपको बताया कि पी टाइप मटेरियल जो पी रीजन में मेजोरिटी कैरियर भी होते हैं, माइनॉरिटी भी होते हैं. ऐसे ही एन रीजन में मेजोरिटी चार्ज कैरियर होते हैं और माइनॉरिटी होते हैं. माइनॉरिटी तो करंट मेजोरिटी के थ्रू की भी जा रही है और करंट का मतलब पी रीजन का होल एन रीजन में पहुंच गया. ये एन रीजन का इलेक्ट्रॉन इधर को आ गया, जंक्शन पार कर गया. तो माइनॉरिटी भी अगर होंगे तो माइनॉरिटी के कारण भी करंट बहेगी. It means current inside the PN junction is the effect of two type of charge, two current, that is current due to majority charge carrier, current by minority charge carrier. So ideally kya hai PN junction mein jab forward bias mein hoga to current behni chahiye aur reverse bias mein ho to current nahi behni chahiye. Aur isliye isko bolte hain diode means first discovered diode wall. Unidirection of current. Current एक ही direction में जा सकती थी. Unidirection flow of current. Current का एक ही direction में flow होना, it is called the you can say property, the characteristic of wall, diode wall. So that's why it is called diode. It means ideal diode में क्या होगा? Ideal PN junction में क्या होगा? केवल forward current बहेगी और reverse current, अगर reverse bias होगा तो current नहीं बहेगी. Next Meenakshi please. Next. Please, next slide. Hello. Meenakshi, please move this slide. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Next, please. Yes, sir. Okay. कुछ questions आ रहे हैं बच्चों की तरफ से?
Sir, last पे ले लेंगे sir questions.
Okay. ठीक है. Okay. आप ना, मैं जल्दी से इसको कर दे रहा हूँ क्योंकि time भी जा रहा है. आप इसको शेयर कर दीजिए फिर से. एक आध स्लाइड है, मैं ये दिखा लेता हूँ.
अच्छा सर, ये स्टॉप हो गई क्या शेयरिंग?
शेयरिंग स्टॉप हो गई. हाँ ओके. हम बात कर रहे थे कि कैसे जंक्शन हमारे लिए यूजफुल है. तो ऐसा काम रेक्टिफायर करता है कि एक केवल करंट पॉजिटिव, एक जैसे एसी है, एसी में पॉजिटिव टाइप की करंट भी होती है और नेगेटिव भी होती है. ओके, बिफोर दैट, इससे पहले वाले में आ जाओ. और पहला हाँ, रिवर्स बायस. ठीक है, तो दो टाइप की बायसिंग है. नेक्स्ट आ जाओ. तो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज अबाउट ऑब्जर्वेशन. हमको ओनली वी हैव टू इंक्रीज द फॉरवर्ड वोल्टेज एंड वी हैव टू मेजर द फॉरवर्ड करंट. और वी आप इसको यू शुड रिमेम्बर इट दैट द ऑर्डर ऑफ मिली एम्पियर है जो करंट, जो फॉरवर्ड करंट है इसका ऑर्डर है मिली एम्पियर. तो करंट ऑफ मिली एम्पियर रेंज फ्लोज इनसाइड पीएन जंक्शन. तो यू हैव टू चेंज एंड सेम केस यू हैव टू इंक्रीज रिवर्स वोल्टेज एंड वी हैव टू मेजर रिवर्स करंट. एंड इट इज यू नो दिस इज अ लेस करंट एंड इट इज ऑर्डर ऑफ माइक्रो एम्पियर. नेक्स्ट. हाँ, तो दिस इज सम ऑब्जर्वेशंस. which is taken in the lab. And interestingly, forward voltage is zero, the current is zero, and it's 0.2 volt, it is again zero. 0.3 volt is again zero, because junction hai, barrier hai potential ka. So current is zero nahi hai. Aur 0.4 volt karenge to thoda sa badh gayi current. Yani ab junction tootna shuru ho raha hai. Aur dheere dheere karke aapka there are 12 reading and next aa jao usme reverse wale mein. Next slide. तो हमारा जो एक्सपेरिमेंट है सिंपल है. हमको फॉरवर्ड वोल्टेज को इंक्रीज करना है और अकॉर्डिंगली हमको फॉरवर्ड करंट मेजर कर लेनी है. वी हैव टू मेजर फॉरवर्ड करंट. बैक स्लाइड पर आइए. एंड सेम थिंग सेम प्रोसीजर्स वी हैव टू डू फॉर रिवर्स बायसिंग. वी हैव टू इंक्रीज रिवर्स वोल्टेज. पहले हमने P को नेगेटिव लगा देना है और N को पॉजिटिव लगाना है, फिर उस वोल्टेज को बढ़ानी है और करंट रिवर्स करंट को पढ़ लेना है. ये माइक्रो एम्पियर रेंज की होगी. नेक्स्ट आ जाओ. तो नाउ आपका काम क्या है, व्हाट इज आवर वर्क. वी हैव टू ड्रॉ द फॉरवर्ड एंड रिवर्स कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ PN जंक्शन डायोड. फॉरवर्ड मीन्स जो the observations which is taken in previous slides. We have to draw characteristics means voltage versus current response, voltage current response of these two. And next aa jao. Next please. This the graph will be like this one. So forward in right section this is the forward bias and left section is the reverse bias. So we can see that in startingly there is no current, almost no current, because current ko rok kon raha hai, junction rok raha hai, aur uske baad achanak se current badh gayi hai kyunki ab aapki jo voltage bahar se aap de rahe hain wo junction ki voltage se zyada ho gayi. And here you can say reverse bias again almost very zero current, very low current. This current is due to minority charge carrier, but after certain voltage current increases. Suddenly the current increases. This is because the some minority charge carrier, suppose ek electron hai, some minority charge carrier hai, it hits, it gets sufficient energy to break the covalent bond. Hum jab negative energy de rahe hain, agar minority charge carrier ek kuch electron wahan par hai to minority charge carrier kya karte hain, unke paas itni sufficient energy aa jayegi ki wo सेमीकंडक्टर के कोवलेंट बॉन्ड को ब्रेक कर देगा और ब्रेकिंग से बहुत सारे चार्ज कैरियर फ्री हो जाएंगे.